Good afternoon. My name is Ken McFadden. I serve as Academic Dean of Union Presbyterian Seminary here on the Richmond campus, and it's an honor to welcome you this afternoon for this time together. This time together is designed to honor and to remember Dr. Katie Geneva Cannon with the unveiling of a portrait. If a picture is worth a thousand words, then a portrait, and this portrait, expresses words that can never be counted or measured. Such is the impact of the life and teaching ministry of Katie. The unveiling of this portrait reminds me of the many ways in which Dr. C unveiled so much in her life and through her work. Those who encountered her in the church and academy, in the classroom and on the public square, gained insight as she unveiled so much that had been hidden from our eyes. She unveiled racism and classism, sexism, and so many other isms. So today we remember her once again, and we give thanks to someone who spoke truth with conviction and with passion, and yet with a gracious style that always welcomed. So welcome.
Katie was one of the finest teachers I have ever met, and the testimony to her work lives on in the students that she encountered across the many decades of her teaching ministry. I don't know a single student who has told me that they were not moved and transformed after sitting in her classroom. I don't know that there is a higher testimony one can give to a teacher. I sat in her classroom and was moved beyond words whenever I heard her lecture, whenever I heard her speak. And I think one of the things that I will always remember is the way in which she could combine a warm and caring smile with a deep, penetrating word of conviction that would make you feel both loved and challenged in the same moment. And I think that's the epitome of what a great teacher is. You go into her classroom and you feel like she loves you, but you also feel like if you don't do the work, there will be a price to pay. Yeah, that's right. Everybody, whether you were taking it for a grade or you were auditing, you did the work in her class because it was important to be a part of a community. She was about creating a community of learning, and to be a part of that community, you had to invest yourself, as she expected her students to then go out from the classroom and invest themselves in what they were doing. We are going to, when the portrait is finally established in the seminary, hang it here in the early center in the reception room so that when students are going to class, they will walk past Katie's portrait. I think it's appropriate that for this wonderful teacher, that her portrait will hang in a building of teaching. I have just a couple of things I wanted to do. One of them is actually, you can see I'm wearing one of the pins. Katie designed these wonderful pins that she worked with the center and also with the Black Alumni Association in many ways kind of share her artistic gifts and talents as well. So I wanted you to know that the Black Alumni Association, if you would like to purchase one of these to remember Katie, they do have them on sale outside in the lobby, and they're $15. And this is one of the last one Veronica tells me of its type. So I guess you might have to fight me for it, perhaps. I don't know, but it'll be out there. But there are other ones that will be out available as well. And all of that helps the work of the center as we continue forward. One other thing I wanted to do was to introduce someone who we will all get to know, I think is going to be a phenomenal teacher and will be a tremendous impact in the life of the academy and the church. Just wonderful gifts and talents that I am excited to have the opportunity to work with. She's going to be a tremendous addition to our faculty. She's going to be an instructor in theology, ethics, and culture. When she finishes her dissertation very soon, she'll be an assistant professor of ethics, theology, and culture, and she will also be the director of the Cady Geneva Cannon Center for Womanist Leadership. Dr. Melanie Jones is with us today. Dr. Jones, would you come here a second? I would appreciate it if you just bring a word of greeting to our community here.
It is so exciting to be here and to be a part of Dr. Cady Geneva Cannon's legacy. One of the things she says, an educated person shares their knowledge. An educated fool beats people up with it. And so I'm happy to be one who shares the knowledge that she has. And I believe that she has given us a legacy that will go on to the future. The future of the center is strong, and the future of womanism is certainly strong.
And we did ask if someone would speak to us from Dr. Cannon's family, and her baby brother, Jerry, is here, Reverend Dr. Jerry Cannon. If you would come and share a few words from the family for us, please.
Good afternoon, Dr. Blount, Mrs. Blount, and Dr. McFadden and staff here at the seminary. It is an honor that we stand to honor our sister, your faculty friend, Cady Geneva Cannon, from the legacy of Emmanuel and Rosa Lytle to Dan and Cor Cannon. We are indeed proud that Cady is honored in this fashion. As you were giving your greetings, Dr. McFadden, I want you to know that the next time that I do a seven last words sermon and somebody takes my word, I'm going to think of you. Because my word was a picture's worth a thousand words. And so you've already stole the thunder. I'll just go to the close. But I think when we see the picture and the portrait of Cady, it will be worth a thousand words for all of those who remember how Cady poured into you and your life. As Dr. Blount says, his presentation as well as his positioning, everyone who walks past that portrait will be able to look at that picture and have multiple words to say and reflect upon it. In closing, I would like to also just bring to our attention, Dr. Blount, as I was thinking of what to say about Cady, and it reminded me of the inferences that she made with Dr. Howard Thurman and that infamous story, A River, Reservoir, and a Swamp, of how she always challenged us not to be that reservoir that simply receives and holds until a time of need, and not necessarily to be that swamp where life flows in and nothing goes out, but to be that river, that transient, that conduit where life flows through. And so on behalf of our mother, who again is here at 99 years old, and let's give God praise for her. She is our queen, and we are grateful. To her namesake, Doris Corrine, my sister, and then my brother John, and my older sister, Sarah, cannot be here, and our other younger sister, Sylvia, cannot be here, and our in-laws, as well as my spouse and niece and nephew, my favorite niece from Jacksonville, Florida, is here, and so we are grateful. We are grateful for just the love shared here, and thank you for this honor.
I also want to take a moment to introduce the artist who painted the portrait for us, Mr. Stanley Rayfield, who has been a wonderful gift to the seminary community. He's painted a few of the portraits that hang here. He is a wonderful artist, and you see some information on the back of the program about him. We are delighted that he's able to be here with us as well for this moment. And I've already told him that I appreciate his work so much that one of these days when you know, the time comes for me to be moving on to the next thing, I want to make sure he's still around somewhere, because you know, he's going to get too famous and he'll be too expensive for us, I imagine. But until that happens, I hope he'll hold a discount in mind for this one presidential portrait when it's time for it to be done and to be hung. I am delighted to introduce Mr. Rayfield to all of you. Did you want to say a word, Stanley, or would you like us just to move on? Okay, come on.
Good afternoon, everybody. So for me, it's always you know, an honor and a blessing to have an opportunity to paint somebody with such a legacy as this. Without having an opportunity to meet her personally, I always just immediately go into prayer and just ask God to help me capture somebody of this magnitude, somebody that he used so greatly as a saint on this, in this earth. And as I just did my research on her, one of the things I've noticed in all the pictures that I looked at is that she had this really piercing gaze that she had in her eyes. And I just said, God, you know, I really want to capture that. I really want to show just that forward look, that way that she was a trailblazer. I just really wanted that to come forward in the eyes. And I'm really happy with the way it turned out. So I'm going to show it to you guys, and, you know, I'm open to any feedback about it. So, you know, God bless you guys, and it's just a pleasure to be here with you guys honoring her. Thank you.
The words of dedication, I just want to share those aloud, and then you see there's a place for all of us to respond together at the end. I declare that this memorial portrait of Dr. Katie Geneva Cannon is dedicated to the glory of God and to the enduring legacy of Dr. Cannon, the Union Presbyterian Seminary, and beyond. Ashe. Thanks be to God. I want to say just before we close that this portrait sat in my office for almost a month, and it was nice to have Katie there on many different occasions to talk to fuss with. And I will say that the very first time, Stanley, that you and Richard Wong brought the portrait over and we put it in, I forgot it was there. And I had to come back, it was like 8:30 at night, to my office, and it was dark. I went into the office running in to get something, and I turned, and I just, you know, ooh. That stare, yeah, it is really, it's really penetrating when you're not ready for it. But it was a delight to be able to share in that special way for the amount of time that I had her in my office. So I'm delighted that our community will now be able to share with her out here in the Early Center. So whenever you come to visit campus alums, she'll be out there, and you can have a chance to walk by. And those of you especially who took classes with her, give thanks.
Normally, when we think of benedictions, We think of speaking words of encouragement and comfort and hope at the end of a worship service when we prepare to go back to our lives and our families and our communities. But this isn't a worship service. It's a ceremony to unveil a portrait, a visual reminder of Katie Geneva Cannon, the trailblazer, teacher, sibling, daughter, aunt, cousin, mentor, and friend, whose life touched and transformed the lives of students, colleagues, families, and acquaintances. R. J. Palacio, author of the book Wonder, writes, "We should be remembered for the things we do. The things we do are the most important things of all. They are more important than what we say or what we look like. The things we do outlast our mortality. They are like the pyramids that Egyptians built in the honor of pharaohs. Only instead of being made out of stone, they are made out of memories of the people. That's why your deeds are like your monuments, built on memories instead of stones." Benediction means good speech, good speak, or to speak well of. So in the spirit of Katie Geneva Cannon, the teacher, you have homework. Invoke benedictions by remembering her for the things she did, speaking well of her. And may those memories of her work and what she taught us, both inside and outside the classroom, be intentionally told to others, expanding her ministry to equip, empower, and set free people to do the work their souls must have. Ashe. Amen.